Fair Fight 1 in Haysi, Virginia, Thursday, July 31st, is brought to you by...
It's Your Fight, Win It! Victory Trophies. Use Victory Trophies for all your trophies and awards. Heritage TV. Local TV and beyond. ZRock 99.3, Tri-Cities New Rock Station. Southern Steel Tattoo, with two locations for your tattoo needs. Pizza Factory, the best pizza in Haysi. Fresh Perspectives Media, where your vision is ours. DJ Cory Chop. Spinning music for all your events. Impact Custom Mouthguards. The best mouthguards in the business. Now let's get to the fight!
Your Fight Promotions is proud to present Fair Fight 1. Fair Fight 1 at the Dickenson County Fair. See what warriors come out on top, and what warriors got choked out, tapped out, or knocked out. Are you ready for this, Haysi, Virginia? Catch all the regional MMA action on Heritage TV. Check your local TV provider now, or go to heritagetv.com. And remember, it's your fight. Win it. Here we are in Haysi, Virginia, the Dickenson County Fairgrounds for Fair Fight 1. My name is Paul Caldy, and I'm here with my beautiful wife,
Stacy Caldy.
We have an action-packed night full of fights, 11 total fights on the fight card. Majority are MMA, and some are grappling.
And we currently have some beautiful weather today, but there is some rain in the forecast.
And I'm predicting some thunder to go down in the cage tonight. Before we start this evening, I'd like to give a special thanks to the Dickenson County Fair for having us this evening. They've been wonderful hosts. And also Fresh Perspectives Media, who's doing all the footage tonight.
We have the marvelous Marvin Stanley.
And Brian Passante as our referees tonight. And of course, the one and the only Slick Rick Caruso as our announcer.
Now let's send it down to Rick and let's get to the fights.
We're going to start off first by honoring our country and the National Guard over here by singing the National Anthem. Allow me to introduce you to Miss Caitlin Ariel, and she's going to take care of singing our National Anthem for us. Can I get the guard to come in here with us, please? Give it up. Let's make a little bit more noise for these people, guys. Will everyone please stand up in all head attire?
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so bright? Stripes in bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave? Ladies and gentlemen, as these men leave our cage, please make a lot of noise for these gentlemen who put their lives on the line so that we can be here to do this. Now let's see if we got this down fast since we're alive now. It's your fight! No. Let me try this over here. Guys, it's your fight! Now let's try this side. We got more people over here, so y'all should win. It's your fight! See, now that's how loud everybody
Let's start off fair fight one. We have Logan Mitchum versus Ty Neese, and they're fighting a 185 weight class.
Ty Neese, fighting out of Big Stone Gap, Virginia, will have a slight reach advantage and height advantage over Logan Mitchum, who is out of Man, West Virginia.
This first fight is brought to you by Victory Trophies.
Victory Trophies is supplying tonight's awards for all the fighters. It seems as both corners are ready to fight. Let's fight!
Couple big blows from Mitchum to start off the round. Looks like Ty's corner is calling for a guillotine, and it looks like he's going to go for it.
Oh, nice reversal by Mitchum as he steps into the takedown and scrambles and looks like he has top position.
Oh, he's taking his back, and now he's smacking him in the head.
Mitchum is landing some big bombs in this dominant position. Oh, he locked into rear naked choke.
And Ty taps.
Mitchum definitely had the technical advantage in this match and used it.
And as usual, the fighters show some great sportsmanship. That's what we like to see. Let's pass it over to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, Lee Marvin's caused a hot stop to this bout at 34 seconds of the first round due to tap out by rear naked choke for your winner, Logan.
Next up, fighting in the 155 weight class, we got Luke Malchano versus Doug Williams.
Luke is going to have a slight height advantage, but Doug Williams is going to have the USMC behind him. Let's take it on down to the cage. The next fight is brought to you by ZRock 99.3, Tri-Cities New Rock. The fighters seem to be feeling each other out. And ooh, Doug goes for a takedown and drops Luke.
Ooh, and Doug mounts him. Looks like he's going for the armbar. Ooh, I think he's got it locked in.
I think he's got it locked in deep.
Looks like Luke taps and Doug comes out with the win.
Hoorah Marine Corps, Doug takes that one home for the troops.
Let's take a look at that replay. Let's take it down to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, your ref Mark Stanley calls a stop to this bout at 21 seconds of the first round. Tap out due to armbar for your winner and United States Marine Corps Doug Double-A Williams.
Doug seemed to be the more technical fighter and he pulls out a technical submission.
This is going to be a good one. We got a grappling match right now. We got Hannah Ellswick up against Robbie Ring, both weighing in at 145.
You know, Stacy, this is one of the matchups I've been looking forward to all night. There's not too many other sports out there where you can see a 14-year-old boy matched up with a 24-year-old woman.
Both fighters seem to be feeling each other out, trying to see where they're comfortable at in the cage. We have Marvelous Marvin Stanley for our official for this bout.
Marvin has worked several fights with us, including the UrFight 1 show back in April, and we plan to have Marvin on our upcoming shows on October 25th in Bristol, Virginia.
We're looking forward to a stacked card for UrFight 2 on October 25th. It's right around the corner. It's just a matter of who's going to take down who first. Now, of course, I got to go with the girl power. I'm going to say, let's go, Hannah.
Whoa. I got Robbie Razor Ring all day. Ooh, and there you go. Robbie takes the first takedown.
Just wait. Let's see what's going to happen. To your left. Pass. It seems like Hannah's covering up nice.
Break the guard open, knee in the center line. Break it open. Elbow in the sweet spot.
Robbie's looking to pass guard.
Rob, knee in the center line, open the feet.
Hannah's been a cage veteran here in the region in MMA, kickboxing, and grappling. And today is Robbie Ring's cage debut. He seems like he's doing well. Hannah's doing a great job of neutralizing any types of advancements Robbie's making.
There you go, good. Two hands on it. You gotta get two hands pulling tight. There you go. You pull it hard. Sit down on your butt.
I'd like to thank all the regional gyms participating here in Fair Fight 1, Advantage Martial Arts, Southwest Martial Arts, Carlos Turner MMA, Team Fast, Team Infidel, and Phoenix MMA. Without these guys, we wouldn't have been able to put on a show tonight. MMA is the fastest growing sport in the world, so why don't you go check out one of these local gyms and see what it's all about.
MMA is just not for fighters. It's also a great workout for men, women, and also kids.
MMA runs a great anti-bullying campaign.
And it's also great for self-defense. There goes Robbie trying to take Hannah's back.
All in all, to this point, it's been a competitive and entertaining match. You mentioned Your Fight 2 is October 25th. There's also a show, Cage Man Challenge, which is going to be on Friday, October 24th at the Bristol High School.
Hey guys, give it up.
Check it out at cagemanchallenge.com.
Some say, let's go, Razor Robbie! Who do we have here, Chip? Let's make some noise for Miss Hannah.
You can also check out urfightsite.com for all the latest news and MMA events. urfightsite.com. I've seen a lot of Your Fight apparel out here tonight.
To get your fight apparel,
no other sport on earth could you watch a 14-year-old man handle a grown woman like this. Go for it, Robbie!
Looks like Hannah's in trouble.
Will she be able to hold on for the next 30 seconds?
Let's hope so.
I said it's your fight!
Looks like Hannah just slipped out of it. Oh no, can Robbie hang on? And it looks like we're gonna finish this one in a draw.
How great was this match? You've got a 14-year-old boy up against a 24-year-old woman. It's super competitive.
Hey guys,
they're learning
from
each other.
I
don't know any other sport around that you can experience something like this. And I really think that the crowd enjoyed this grappling match. Let's take it down the ring.
And another round of applause for the cannibal, Hannah Elswick.
Next up, we got Gil Goncalves versus Billy Jessup at a catch weight of 145.
Next up is a grappling match brought to you by Southern Steel Tattoo. They're giving away a $150 tattoo gift certificate tonight at the Dickenson County Fair. Gil fights out of Tazewell, Virginia, and Billy fights out of Holden, West Virginia. Both fighters accepted this matchup late today. Billy has more of a boxing and stand-up background, while Gil is more jiu-jitsu and grappling.
That's one great thing about this sport. You always have things that you need to work on. This is going to be a perfect example of that tonight. And once again, we see in the cage marvelous Marvin Stanley.
There's no doubt Gil feels comfortable on the ground. Let's see how Billy's strength works against Gil's technique. I'd like to give a special shout out to the Dickenson County Fair. Without these guys, we wouldn't be able to do Fair Fight 1 this year. Thanks, guys.
And it looks like Gil's walking in a triangle.
Now you can see how Billy's been able to power out of some of Gil's submission attempts, but let's see what happens.
Oh, it's locked in deep. No doubt, just like you said, you can tell that Gil's very comfortable on the ground.
Let's see how...
Oh, looks like Billy just tapped.
Once again, much respect to both of these athletes for taking this matchup last minute. Let's take it down to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for our competitors in this one. The winner by triangle choke, Gil Goncalves. Humanos que só julgam se enxergam pouco. Humanos que nem os gostam muito de falar, mas não conhecem nem o querem aceitar.
Now, Stacy, it's been a long day today. Why don't we go back and see how this day started?
Away to Fair Fight 1's brought to you by UrFight. Here we go. Look at that. Good job, Paul. Good job.
Everyone.
Thank you.
Probably about 15 minutes into the trip. And look at the crazy monster fell asleep. It looks so comfy.
I know, right? That's why I want to sit in the back.
Brandon.
Look at her seatbelt.
Crazy monster.
Look at her seatbelt.
Booby Doo. And Alina.
What's up? This is Paul with UrFight, and this is the UrFight Roadshow. Today we're heading to Fair Fight 1, presented by UrFight. We're heading up into Haysi, Virginia. First time they're ever going to put a cage up there. We're going to be at the Dickenson County Fair. Tickets are only $6. That's some crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. Got a couple shout outs for some sponsors that are helping us with the show. Shout out to Victory Trophies. They're going to be presenting all the awards for all the warriors that are going to be battling it out tonight. Definitely got to do a shout out to ZRock, best radio station in the Tri-Cities. Also need to shout out Heritage TV. They're going to make us famous. They're giving us a TV spot, so this might make the cut. Probably not. Gotta also do a shout out for Impact Custom Mouthguards. These guys have been they've been with us from day one. Great company. Best mouthguards in the business by far. Fair Fight 1. Going down tonight. Come out. Get Haysi's best pizza from the Pizza Factory. They're hooking us up with some pizzas tonight. It's going to be a fun time. MMA is going to Haysi. Get ready.
drive 9.1 miles on Clinton Highway.
And we're on our way to Haysi. More miles of this.
Haysi. I can just imagine all the stuff in the trailer flying all over the place. Haysi. Here we go. Let's just say, fights tonight!
Turn left on Dickenson Highway.
Nice little sign for the fair back there.
9.3 miles. Then turn left on Haysi Main Street. The Fair Fight 1 in Haysi, Virginia. Things are coming together. We got the UrFight booth over there. We got the sponsors on the cage. We got the fighters ready to throw down. Fair Fight 1. Special thanks to all the fair sponsors.
Johnson Chevrolet Buick, EQT Productions, Range Resources, E&S Grocery, Stone Mountain Health Services, WDIC Radio, Ramey Enterprises, Dickenson County Behavioral Health Services, Dickenson County Home Health, Appalachian Agency for Senior Citizens, Town of Haysi, E. Dillon and Company, McFall Excavation Company, Thompson and Litton Engineering, Superior Fabrication, Electric Hardwoods, Ritter Circle Metal, Appalachian Power Sports, Belcher Insurance, Jones and Counts Pharmacy, West End Pharmacy, Davis Service Center.
Next up is a catchweight match at 145 pounds with Ray Holston versus Devin McKenzie.
We got Devin coming all the way from Ohio for this fight. And then we have Ray Holston coming from Bland, Virginia.
This fight is brought to you by the Pizza Factory, the best pizza in Haysi. Come on out to the Pizza Factory.
Devin, at the age of 16, is making his cage debut today.
Both fighters are feeling each other out with the jabs.
And it looks like Devin's pulled guard.
And Ray just gained side control.
Devin,
I got right work. Settle.
You're fine.
Settle. Pressure into the cage when you're ready.
Throw that knee right to his wrist.
All right, let me keep squeezing, Ray.
You're going to squeeze off that, all right?
Ray Ray has continued to pressure Devin, but Devin's looking strong with some defense.
You gotta move, Ray. There you go, good, good, good. There you go. Position.
I got
to
step
over
that arm
just
like me. There you go.
Hey.
There you go.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. He got up. Devin just got up. Ooh. That hurt.
What's from out? What's from out?
Ray Ray with a giant slam. Ray Ray again continues to advance on Devin.
Right there, you always out there.
Right, look for that palm through. Knee, Ray. Good. Posture up. Position. Calm down. Calm. Posture up.
Four. Ray Ray with the full mount.
Don't let him touch your arm, Ray.
Hard. Everything you got, Ray.
Come on, Ray. Go from the ceiling.
Raining down blows on Devin.
Good. There you go. Hard. Keep it hard.
And a fist down the middle.
Ray Ray showing great patience. Marvelous Marvin's looking in. Is he going to stop this?
Devin's protecting himself.
Get it up, Benista.
He needs to fight back. Oh.
Good fight, guys. Good fight. Let's send it down to Ray.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for this 16-year-old making his debut this evening. That was a tough fight, and man, had a lot of heart taking the fight on an hour's notice. Let's give them both a round of applause. Let's tell them both to always remember, it's your fight. Yeah! Your referee, Stanley, calls a halt to this bout. At a minute 39 of the first round, TKO due to strikes. Real winner, Ray Ray. Say it twice. Halston. Give a round of applause for Devin. One shot, McKenzie. Your rep of this match be Brian Pisani.
And now it's time for Jeremy Mullins to take on Sean Riviera, weighing in at 185.
Riviera is fighting out of Princeton, West Virginia, and Mullins is fighting out of Wise, Virginia. This fight is brought to you by Fresh Perspectives Media.
Where your vision is our vision.
Are you ready? Fight!
Whoa, both fighters come out swinging.
This is either going to end real fast or it's not going to end so good.
Both fighters are swinging.
Oh, wow. Riviera is just nailing it.
Oh, in the knee. Riviera goes for the back, looking to lock in a choke.
Never give a fighter your back. Big mistake. Mullins might be in trouble.
Tries to roll. Nice cover up.
Get away, stand up.
Riviera really wants this one.
Mullins needs to do something. Oh, and the fight gets stopped. Riviera looks fired up. He wants to go again. Oh, what was that, Mr. Riviera?
Holy smokes.
Let's see that again. Some big blows from up top.
That was a great fight, guys. Great fight.
Hey, Si, what?
Let's send it down to Rick.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Brian Pisani, calls a stop to this bout. TKO due to strike for your winner at 53 seconds of the first round, Sean Paco Riviera! Team what?
professional fighter J.J. Stewart versus a not professional fighter Harvey Addison.
I think it would be best if Rick tells a story, so let's pass it over to Rick.
I need your undivided attention for just a couple of moments about our next match. Our next match is a grappling match. Our next match is very important to me. Our next match is between J.J. Stewart and Harvey Addison. J.J. Stewart is a pro fighter. This man's a pro fighter, a heck of a pro fighter at 185 pounds, representing Team Fast. All right? Harvey Addison is not a fighter. This man has never fought a day in his life. This man is a grappler, though. The kicker about Harvey is blind. This man is 90% blind. He has been training with me since I moved to the state of West Virginia for 4 years. Since I met this man, his dream has been to get inside this cage. Well, this man's 90% blind. There's no chance of him ever getting inside of this cage. Until tonight. Because J.J. Stewart is not only a heck of a fighter, but a heck of a man that accepted a grappling match. He contacted me looking for a grappling match. J.J. Stewart is so good of a pro fighter, it's very hard to find a grappling match for him. Then one Sunday at church, I'm sitting here on the phone with Harvey about getting ready to go do a cookout, and it clicked in my head. Let me help Harvey's dream come true. Let me see if this professional fighter would want to grapple Harvey. Now, Harvey's a little bit bigger than him, but he's not a fighter. JJ answered me with absolutely no hesitation to take this fight, which I'm 26 years old and a grown man, and that brought me to tears because JJ helped me bring one of my best friend's dreams come true. So when this man comes out, I want y'all to continuously make noise the entire time for this fight. Let's welcome to the cage, Mr. Harvey Addison! Professional fighter from Team Fast, please welcome J.J. Stewart!
Signed shirt, I'm sincere. This year I'm in here, I'll spell it out to make things clear. And meanwhile, your end's near, I've got a lane and I'm in gear. You people wonder who's next up, that conversation really ends here. You rappers just talk a bunch, stress me out, I chop a Dutch. Weak rappers trying to bite the sound, but my style is a lot to munch. And I'm more like whiskey meat, and you're more like vodka punch. G's dope, you might blow up, think I know, I've got a hunch. My side is authentic, you try to stump this star in it. Sure don't get a bad champion, cool bro. She wears a ring, can't do without it.
Hey guys, make some noise for our ring girl.
Cause I'm fucking your girlfriend and there's nothing.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce our opponents one more time. Remember, this is a grappling match. No strikes, no kicks, no nothing but wrestling and submissions. 1 5-minute round. Introducing to my left, this man is wearing the blue rash guard, black and pink trunks. This man is 90% blind, and these gentlemen will be starting off blind, meaning touching hands when the rings. Please welcome, representing Team Advantage out of Princeton, West Virginia, Harvey Addison! And his opponent, standing across the cage, wearing the black rash guard and green valley tutos, please welcome, Pro J.J. Stewart!
With these special circumstances, there have been some rule modifications, as you can see at the start of this fight.
As you can hear, Harvey definitely picked up a lot of fans.
and definitely a lot of props to JJ. He told me before this match that he said he's not going to hold back. Harvey's going to have to beat him.
That just shows the true competitive nature of this sport. Harvey's using his size advantage to throw JJ off.
Looks like JJ is going for an armbar.
Harvey's doing a great job of protecting himself, but can he hold it till the end of the round? Looks like Harvey tapped, but you gotta give the guy mad props. Listen to that crowd. They absolutely love Harvey and JJ.
No other sport can I see something like this.
Ladies and gentlemen, give it a round of applause for these two gentlemen again. Remember, it's your fight! I said it's your fight! I said it's your fight! That's it, guys. Your referee, Pisani, calls a halt to this bout at 2 minutes of the first round due to armbar for your winner, JJ Stewart. Hey, guys, give it a round of applause for JJ for taking this fight and helping this man's dream come true. We're going to have a quick chit-chat with Mr. Harvey here. Harvey. I know it's a little emotional, and it ain't even emotional because of pain. It's emotional because that's the realization of a dream coming true. How'd that feel to be in here, brother? Undescribable. Harvey, since I met you, man, you've been nothing. Probably one of the best friends I've ever had. You bailed me out of spots when I needed them. This was the least I could do for you, man. Thank you for your friendship to me. Let's give it up to JJ Stewart! I want to thank JJ for taking this fight. He didn't have to, but he did. Let's give it up for Mr. Addison here. It takes a lot to walk around every day like this man does and then step in here and be a competitor too.
Fair Fight 1 in Haysi, Virginia, Thursday, July 31st, is brought to you by...
It's Your Fight, Win It! Victory Trophies. Use Victory Trophies for all your trophies and awards. Heritage TV. Local TV and beyond. ZRock 99.3, Tri-Cities New Rock Station. Southern Steel Tattoo, with two locations for your tattoo needs. Pizza Factory, the best pizza in Haysi. Fresh Perspectives Media, where your vision is ours. DJ Cory Chop. Big music for all your events. Impact Custom Mouthguards. The best mouthguards in the business.
Now let's get to the fight!
Your referee for this bout, Brock Pisani.
Next to go into the cage is Terrendous Bryan versus Andre Gamble, fighting in at 185.
Gamble's fighting out of Hurley, Virginia, and Bryan is fighting out of Logan, West Virginia.
This fight is brought to you by Impact Custom Mouthguards.
Now, Andre took this fight on late notice, so we knew he's always game to fight. He came out, and let's see what he can do. Both fighters look comfortable on their feet. Bryan pushes Gamble over to the cage. Seems like the fans are getting a little rowdy on this one. We've had beautiful weather today so far here in Haysi, and I'm hoping it can hold off. It might look like there might be some rain out there.
Oh, you see that?
Gamble gets on top of Bryant.
Let's make some noise. Mounts him.
Let's see if he can posture up. Brian's doing a good job of holding on.
He needs to try to switch positions.
What we tell him, ladies and gentlemen, it's your fight!
Get out there, you nigga!
Campbell's definitely winning this round. He's been in control just about the entire fight.
Brian's not giving up easy.
Oh, nice reversal. Back in control.
Body! Body, body, body!
Looked like he just waved to the crowd. Take my picture, please. Gamble's trying to posture up to do some more ground and pound. Needs to do something. Round's about to end.
And the fight stopped.
Gamble was looking impressive this first round, dominating it on the ground.
And we want to thank our ring girls, Bianca and Caitlin, for this round.
Once again, we'd like to thank Southern Steel Tattoo for donating a $150 tattoo gift certificate.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to do another 50-50 drawing, another ticket drawing after this fight. We're going to go about 5 minutes, and then we're going to draw. Make sure you get your tickets. We got 50-50 raffle, tattoo raffle. That's a $150 tattoo gift certificate, guys.
Starting here in round two, Bryant's really going to have to change his game plan. Both fighters ready to fight. Gamble looks a little bit tired.
Bryant, he wants this now. He definitely wants this fight.
In round one, Gamble seemed to have the best on the ground. Not sure if Bryant wants to go back down there. Couple big blows landed by Bryant. Gander with a nice roll. He's going to have to do something. Oh, the referee stops in and stops this fight. Bryant's definitely excited. I think he wants to fight some more. Take a look at this replay. This is from round one and this is round two. Seemed like two completely different fighters in each round.
Let's send it down the road.
Good job.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Brian Pisani, calls a halt to this bout at 1 minute of the second round due to strikes for your winner, Tremendous
These guys need to be in a pack.
Next up is the Fair Fight 1 co-main event. Sam Baker versus Nathan Lawson.
Both these guys are weighing in at 155.
Sam is fighting out of Bluefield, West Virginia, and Nate is fighting out of Wise, Virginia. Both fighters touch gloves. Sam comes out swinging. Nathan Lawson's covering up well. Sam looks like a crazy man, swinging at will. Nice slam by Sam Bam Bam Baker. Looks like Sam's complete dominating this first round. Throwing down balls from the top. What was that? Nice reversal by Nate. Sam said, get back on the ground. Nathan gets back up. Sam keeps swinging for the fences. Nice knee by Nate. And Sam takes the top position with the mount. No doubt the most action we've seen tonight.
Nathan needs to be something here if he wants to win this round.
He's doing a great job holding Sam at will. Sam is able to posture up, landing some bombs. Ace has to do something. Nice couple punches from the bottom by Nate. Armbar. Sam Baker's going for the armbar. Looks like he has it in pretty good.
Oh, that was painful.
Look at that heart by Nate. Now he's on top position. Nate's trying to do some damage from the top position.
Come on, guys. Y'all can make some more noise for this one.
Sam doing a good job in half guard.
Y'all better
Nate's
tell
trying to slip it.
It's your fight. It's your fight.
He got
top
it's
position. Pull him out. Let's see if he can fox her up and do some damage. A little payback for Bam Bam. Now, to stay on top of all the MMA action, make sure you text UrFight to 90210. We're getting close here to the end of the round. Let's see if any of the fighters can do anything at the end. Looks like both fighters just scrambled to the floor. Sam thinks he won. Ref hasn't called it yet. End of round one. Way to end an action-packed round one. Bam Bam thinks he won it, but he was just informed by the ref that we're going to go to round two. Let's watch this again. Watch this by Nate. Nice reversal. I don't think Sam knew what happened there. And Sam goes for the armbar here. Looks like I thought he was going to get Nate to tap on this.
Everyone, step back from the cage. If you are not a corner person,
and then of course a scramble at the end with a big left hook. Put Nate in some different time zone right there. We're heading to round two. Hoping the weather can stay off.
He wants Sam Bam Bam Baker to get this one.
We can see Bam Bam with his corner. Professional fighter Derek Lambert.
Y'all tell him it's your fight. It's your fight.
Rick's it's doing a great fight. Job pumping up the crowd. We're heading to round two.
This fight is brought to you by Pizza Factory,
the best pizza in Haysi. Go out to Pizza Factory and get your guys a slice tonight.
Nate took a big left hook at the end of round one. I'm not sure if he can recover after that. Let's Brian Pisani checking with both fighters. Looks like Nate has a problem. I don't know if he's going to be able to continue. Nope, Brian Pisani calls this fight. Nate wasn't able to answer the bell. Sam comes over, congratulates both fighters. Great sportsmanship. Let's send it down the ring.
Due to his opponent unable to the second round bell, Sam, Bam Bam Baker! Ladies, y'all, let's fall. I can't take no selfies now. And your winner, Sam Bam Bam Baker!
Next up, we got Chandler Cole fighting Mikey Furrier. Mikey came all the way from Ohio for this fight. I know he wants this one.
Chandler's coming in with an impressive undefeated record, also holding a few championship belts. Mikey's coming from Portsmouth, Ohio. Both standing in around 5'10", 5'11", and weighing in at a catch weight of 225. UrFight 1, main event. Here we go. The main event is brought to you by Victory Trophies. Go to Victory Trophies for all your trophies and award needs. Victory Trophies. Thanks again, guys, for supplying all these warriors with all the trophies and medals tonight. Victory Trophies. As round one's about to begin, we're looking at the weather and hoping the rain can hold off for this main event. Mikey has an impressive stand-up game with a boxing background, and you can see Chandler wanted nothing at that. Took him straight to the ground, first takedown. Throwing some big elbows.
Mikey's got to get up.
Mikey's doing a good job covering up. You can see the beautiful skylines in the background with some clouds rolling in. Chandler's bringing the thunder in the cage.
This guy's over here sticking his tongue out of the cage.
Mike is going to have to get this fight on his feet if he wants a chance to win. Chandler just looks too strong on the ground.
What do we tell him, guys? It's your fight!
I'm not sure if you felt that, Stacy, but I felt some rain.
It's your fight!
You can see some rain's coming down in the cage. This is definitely going to cause some problems for the fighters.
Where else do we get down in the rain?
Chandler continuing to do work from the dominant position.
The rain doesn't seem to be bothering them.
Looks like they are getting a little bit slippery in there. Rain's coming down a little bit harder. Big hits coming down from Chandler. You can see the mat's almost all wet now.
Chandler's not even fazed by the rain. He's just throwing them punches.
Crowd's starting to get a little bit rowdy. I think the rain's definitely starting to become a problem for the fighters.
15 seconds left to go.
Chandler bringing the thunder. Whoa!
It's a slide time.
Whoa! We're definitely have to go to the ref to see if they can continue with these conditions. Great sportsmanship, great battle for the first round. Let's go to round two. We can see the officials getting together to see if they should stop the action or if they should continue with the fights. Of course, the most important thing is the fighter safety, so if there's any type of concerns, they will call this match.
This ain't baseball, ain't no playing the way.
Seems like the fans definitely want some more action in there.
It looks like this fight's going to be called due to the rain. It's going to be rolled as a no contest.
So we're just getting back from Fair Fight 1. Quick little UrFight roadshow weekend on the apparel side, but definitely a long day on the UrFight promotion side. Definitely have to say Fair Fight 1 was a tremendous success. We had about 300 to 350 people cage side, about 400 people in the grandstands. We had all the people on the guardrails and up in the bleachers, and seemed like everybody had a good time, even though our main event got rained out. Got one round in with Chandler Cole and Mikey Chocolate Drop. So we'll see if we can get those two guys back in the cage sometime soon, because definitely think the fans wanted to see that. Hayside, Virginia. People asked us why we're going to do a show in Hayside. I think we answered that. UrFight Roadshow.
Boom! Special thanks to all the fair sponsors:
Johnson Chevrolet Buick, EQT Productions, Range Resources, E&S Grocery, Stone Mountain Health Services, WDIC Radio, Ramey Enterprises, Dickenson County Behavioral Health Services, Dickenson County Home Health, Appalachian Agency for Senior Citizens, Town of Haysi, E. Dillon and Company, McFall Excavation Company, Thompson and Litton Engineering, Superior Fabrication, Electric Hardwoods, Ritter Circle Metal, Appalachian Power Sports, Belcher Insurance, Jones and Counts Pharmacy, West End Pharmacy, Davis Service Center.